Hi, I'm Mark. Welcome back to Foothill Paint Fabrication. Well, we're back on Project Ruby today, and we're going to take care of all the small stuff. We're going to get the rocker moldings off, emblems, taillights, headlights, bumpers, everything we can get off this car in preparation for starting taking the big body panels off, so ultimately we can lift that body off the chassis. So let's just jump right in here and get to work. Okay, Ruby's looking a little bare with no windows in it. Let me get this thing up in the air a little bit higher so I can get underneath it, get those bumper bolts. I soaked all the bolts I could find with some PB Blaster over the last few days. Hopefully these bolts will come out without much trouble. And then we can get to work on these rockers and everything. These stainless steel moldings are in really good shape, and I certainly want to make sure I take care of taking them off. Okay, I've got my helper right here, my little rolling seat. It's pneumatic, so I just slide it in and jack it up so it'll hold the bumper in place, hopefully, so it doesn't fall on my head. It's in there a little loose, but we'll see what happens. Let's see if we can't get these bolts out. This one's got a lot of shims in it. I'm gonna have to check the frame snout on the front here, see if it's been bent in. I don't remember it being bent in, but who knows. Ow! Yeah, I love that. Came off pretty nice. Nothing looks too bent up. This bumper is pretty bent up though. A lot of damage up underneath. So it's gonna have to be straightened before it gets replated. Okay, while we're up here, let's just go ahead and get the rest of this stuff off. We'll get the headlights and the grill off. Okay, let's go ahead and get this off. Just take the whole piece of sheet metal and the grill and everything off at once. Okay, we'll get these out and it should come off. Okay, got it. Okay, before we move on to the back bumper, let's go ahead and get these headlights out. It's got a pellet hole right there. Somebody shot a hole in that. It's probably, I hate to say it was me, but it's probably me shooting at a squirrel and had a pellet go way off. And all I have to do is get the cans out then. All right, let's see if we can get these cans out. Pop the screws out of their slots. Hook it off the spring. Good to go. These adjuster things are plastic back there. They need to be replaced. I can get these parts too. Hopefully I can. GM used the same parts on all of them. So once we get the fender off, I can lay it on the bench. I can get these springs out. They are kind of a bear to get out of there, but we got the bulk of it. Let's go ahead and move to the back, get that rear bumper off. Okay, let's go ahead and get this bumper off. I already got the wires loose for the backup lights and the license plate. They just feed up inside the trunk through some rubber plugs, so I got those undone. We're gonna go ahead and get these loose right here, just a little bit. All right, let's get these out. Handy helper here. There we go. Okay. All right, here we go. Maybe. Whoa. This one's in a lot better shape than the front one. Okay, let's get these taillights and rear trim off right here. Okay, these should go pretty quick. Pop those taillights out. Already hit everything with some PB Blaster. Make it go quick. Have a gasket, and they're known to leak because the water runs down at an angle and ends up in the trunk, so I may have put some sealer on here all those years ago, and they don't feel like they want to come out. All right, we'll try a little pry bar here, medium-sized pry bar. Boy, kind of feels like Mark put something on there. Dang it, I can hear it popping. I don't want to bend this back panel. I don't see any way to get a knife or anything down in there. There it goes. Gotta let it come out slowly, I guess. There. Oh, this side. Here pretty good. There we go. Oh, it's still glued on there. All right, this housing's good too. No cracks in it. I didn't break anything. The gasket was stuck on there. I may have put some sealant on it. I don't know. But yeah, hey, we got those out in one piece. Score. Let's get the trim off. We've got some trim around the quarters right here and then on the trunk up here. So let's go ahead and get that. Okay, let's see if we can get these out of here. Well, that's one way to get it off. The clip spun inside there and released. There's supposed to be a screw at the bottom, but Mark didn't put that screw in all those years ago. All right, well, we got them off, and they're looking in great condition. Okay, so let's go ahead and get this one off here. This is the one that lines up with it. And this is just little tiny screws across the backside, and then we've got the GTO emblem on the other end. Okay, we just have this molding to take off and this emblem. Now, years ago, I picked up this little ratcheting screwdriver, and it works great. You can change direction. The best part about it is you can change tips, and I really like it because I can push up against this part right here really hard while I'm trying to get it out, and you got plenty of leverage, especially for up inside here because you can't really get a screwdriver up in there. So we only got a couple of screws left to get out. The one on the very end down here, I had to drill out and then hit it with a chisel to get it to come out a little bit, and then I got a pair of pliers on it, pulled it out, kind of just drove it out. I didn't really didn't really unscrew it. It kind of pulled out, but I can fix the clip that it came out of. Shouldn't be a problem. I've got a squeeze clamp down there right now holding up the molding so it doesn't bend when I take the last screw out here. All right, so it's pretty much loose. Turns out there was only 4 screws in the whole thing, and it takes a lot more screws than that. But we got this off. Let's go ahead and get this GTO emblem off, and we are about done right here. Move on. All right. Now these lower rockers, they just have some screws that go up into the bottom, and then this just kind of hooks on there and pulls down, so should be pretty easy. Let's see what's underneath this thing. So we just pry it away a little bit. A little bump with my fist. Should come right off the clip, just like that. Well, not bad underneath this one. I know the other side's not so nice. All right, let's get this beauty ring off around the wheel well here. These are kind of beat up. I did make cuts along here and bend these up because my tires were rubbing. This isn't the original tire. I stuck that on there because the other one was flat. But I don't know if we can reuse these or not. They're pretty beat up. We'll try to straighten them. Okay, we got one hidden back in the wheel well here. And the rest will be just like the back one, pretty sure. This one's kind of long and skinny, so we've got to be careful not to kink it. I think there's screws at least right here. So let me get this door open. We'll see if that screw's there. Well, there's supposed to be a screw there. Brackets out of here. Yeah, this one's got a few dingers in it, little crease right here, but not too hard to straighten. Get this thing polished up, look like brand new again. All right, we got the one for the door here, which I don't really remember there's a screw here. You can probably screw at the other end. I don't know if there's any on the inside of the door or if these are blind clips. Okay, there are clips on the inside that need to be compressed. There we go. Alright. Didn't even drop it. Looks good too. Alright, one more and we are done. So this one is chrome plated. The rest are all stainless, stamped stainless, but this one has to be replated so it matches. It actually doesn't look bad, but it's got some pretty good pits right there. But it's all gonna look brand new when we're done. Okay guys, Ruby's looking more stripped down than she was, that's for sure, before we started today. We got a good day's work in. I was just looking at this down here once I got that molding off. That looks worse than it is. It's actually less than 1/8 inch thick. I just peeled some off. But we may need to put patch panels down here anyways, could be rusted out, but we'll find out once it comes back from being dipped. Back here around the tail lights, I was really concerned because there was a lot of rust right here, right on the edge, but it's pretty sound, feels pretty good. So that's good news. Like I said earlier, I really wish I would have stored the car better. It certainly wouldn't be in this condition if I would have stored it better over all those years, but I stored it at my sister's for a while. I stored it here, you know, out to try to keep it covered. But, you know, once stuff gets in there and the rain gets in, then it just turns into mush and the water just sits there and causes damage. So, But, I mean, it's all here. I can deal with whatever we find. But all in all, it's a pretty sound car. Pretty happy about the way everything's going. Am finding some stuff that's kind of making me remember things I did back, you know, when I was just a youngster. But hey, I got the skills, I got the time, I got the money now, so we're going to make it beautiful. We got a pretty good pile of parts we pulled off today. Now these bumpers, and you do need to be straightened and replated, obviously. The rear bumpers, the little slot for, remember you put the bumper jack inside the slot and raise up the car. Those are all going to be filled in. Some holes that were drilled in it for, I don't know, before I got my car. But those are going to work out good. All the stainless looks really good. I got to find those, the beauty rings or the wheel well rings for the front. I hope I have them. But all this stuff can be either straightened and repolished or replated, so I don't have to hunt down for a bunch of stuff. So it's pretty good news today. Pretty good day of work and got some good news. Okay guys, that pretty much wraps up this video on Project Ruby. Got a lot of good work done today, got some good surprises and some not so good surprises, but you know, really that car is pretty sound, so I shouldn't really complain. We got all the bumpers off, moldings, emblems, we got all that stuff off, so the next step really is to get doors, body panels, hood, you know, all that stuff off and prep it and get ready to lift that body off that chassis, but that'll be coming up. Thanks for joining me here at Foothill Paint and Fabrication. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button if you haven't already. Mash that bell and drop me a comment. I'd love to hear from you guys. We'll see you on the next one.